Hey guys, I'm going to be doing a Halloween marbling tutorial. So if you are interested in seeing what I'm going to do, you can stay tuned and watch how I do this. Okay, what I'm doing is I'm just using some fake nails like I always do. And what I did is I went and I did a white base color. So I already went ahead and painted them all white. Depending on how you want them, you can do one or two coats. The Sally Hansen's Extreme Wear and White Out or White On. One coat is really all you need. So the colors I'm going to be using is Blackout, Celeb City. Oops, you probably couldn't see that. Sunkissed. And Mellow Yellow. So what you're gonna do is you can go in any order you want, but I'm gonna go with black, the silver, the orange, and then the yellow. So let's get started. Also, you're gonna want your room temperature water. Make sure it's not cold, otherwise it's not gonna work. And if it's too hot, it might not work either. So you want room temperature. Let's go ahead and get started. Get my first drop off here. You want to work at a decent pace, otherwise it's going to dry up and you're going to have to start all over again. I find that these nail polishes work really, really good for this. So if you're really into marble, water marbling your nails, I highly recommend these nail polishes. I also think it's got a lot to do with your timing, or not your timing, but like how, like room temperature your water is. If it's too cold, it's not gonna work. If it's too hot, it's probably not gonna work. But you want to make sure you just work at a decent pace, your water temperature dry, and I highly recommend these nail polishes for this. So what I'm going to do is, as you can see right here, you can see how that came out. Now you're just going to take your toothpick and just go ahead and do it. Do a design. See what happens? It kind of got stuck to the edge and now I have to start all over. Lovely. Sometimes it works okay, sometimes it doesn't. You're gonna have probably a couple that do, a couple that don't. Alright, let's try this again. I'm only gonna do, I do two layers of each, and you can kind of just do whatever order you want. Doesn't really make a difference in what colors or how many. I mean, I say the limit's about 4, maybe 5 colors, but I think 4 is like plenty. But alright, let's go. Let's make our design. You know, kind of, I like to kind of give it a little bit of a swirl. Maybe some of the black in here. Okay, I'm just going to take my nail. You're going to want to put it down with the white down first. Just pick a spot and go for it. And you're going to want to hold it down just for a little bit, so it seals itself, and then just go around and collect all the extra. I'm just using a really old towel that I'm really never gonna use again, which I highly recommend using something that you're not gonna use again. So that's how that one turned out. Next one, I'm just gonna kind of go in any order. That way I'm not wasting. I'm gonna try and get all these in before my time is up. But I mean, you can go in pretty much any order you want. I'm just kind of doing any random color now. I'm not going in any particular order. Oops, and I just got nail polish all over the place. Alright. Now we're gonna go back in and do a design. Kind of do whatever design. Picking my other nail, just place it where you want, and I'm gonna take another one since I have time and just dip. And if you can, just kind of hold them separately apart and get all the excess. And that's how that one looks. Okay, now I've got two more. I'm gonna go back in and kind of gather up any other mess. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and start off and just do any random order again. I'm not gonna go in any specific order here. This is really fun for like little kids to do, like little girls, if you have a daughter. Just really fun, and you know how little girls, I have a daughter myself, and she likes to have her nails done, so. Okay. We go back in and make our design. Take my other nail and just find a spot and dip. And take my last nail, find another spot, and so try and hold them separate apart. Just kind of get up all this stuff again, all the extras. And this one didn't really get any orange on it, but that's what that one looks like. And that's what that one looks like. Now if you want to add like any rhinestones or anything, you can. All you do is you can either decorate them, leave them like this, just put your top coat on, which I'm going to do here in a second. You can add glitter, you can do whatever you want, so. But this is my Halloween water marbling tutorial. Sorry, I can't speak tonight. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope you enjoy my Halloween series of nails. Thank you. Bye.